Right, we're on the ferry, just about to land in Calais for our July trip to Lepinet South with angling lines. Just came back from the Roussie in March, the end of March, and then this is an in-betweener before we choose another lake for September. So there's me and brother-in-law Billy. And we do a proper introduction and everything when we get there, so I'm not going to do too much about the journey and everything because we all know what that entails. But we'll be arriving in Calais at 11 o'clock French time, so we should be down. It's east of Le Mans, 5 hour comfortable. Should be down there for about 5-6 in the morning. Got the gate code 2 hours early, 2 days early than the trip, so it's Wednesday night now. Arrive Thursday morning, so we do the Thursday and Friday extra, and then the Saturday to Saturday normal fishing. Went there last March, so it's my return trip. First session in the March, I've done the 22 free fish, which I've put that up, and had the 150-pound sturgeon, which we're hoping to get again this trip. Billy wants to have that one in the net, just for the experience of that size fish, to be fair. So, yeah, I'll do as much as I can. I'm gonna try and probably do a long blog on this one. The weather's going to be very, very hot. Friday's forecast at 32 degrees. Doesn't put me off with the high pressure and everything. Not on the French fishing trips. A lot of people say, haven't caught, you know, too high pressures. That's what French fishing is. Throughout the summer, you know, you get some great fish. So, we'll see. And once we're all settled in, got the first beer opened, and I'll sit down and have a show you the lake and talk through what we're going to be doing, and then keep you updated throughout. I'm Brian.
And I'm Billy.
And we're at Lac de Nepalais. So, we've arrived a little bit early, 6 o'clock in the morning. Just parked up. And now, it's all about getting set up. We've got a long day ahead of us. It's been a long day. So, we're pretty tired, but once you get that setting up done, enjoy the afternoon. Nice meal tonight, looking forward to it. Look at that lake, lovely, nice big spacious double swim, and our fishing area is from here to here, halfway across Lac de Lepinet. Some nice 60s in here. Someone fishing up there. It looks like they've gone from 2 to 3. They go Saturday, so we've got 2 days with them next to us. Then we've got the whole side to ourselves. And someone's coming into zero on Saturday next to us to our right. He's gonna be fishing that end bay. That's the situation at the moment. The rods have only gone out the first time today. We didn't do them this morning. We walked down to the village. I think I've got a bream there. There's a lot of bream in here. Anyway. So that's the situation at the moment. I don't know if I showed my setup, but this is the final setup. Look at that.
To your chest. Ready, ready.
Right, Saturday morning, it's about 8:30. Just waiting for the owner to come round to give us the boat for the week. Really hectic night. Had probably one of the worst storms I've been in. I'm gonna put some footage up of that. Bill took some pictures last night, 2 o'clock in the morning it was. And we had 4 fish. One before the storm, 3 after the storm. We had a brace of 36 common and a 36 mirror. So we had no choice just to retain it with that storm, really bad electrical storm. And at first light, gets light here, probably about 4:30, about 5:30, 5:30. So we got up early, and not that we had a lot of sleep, but we was basically up anyway. We just waited for the light to come up, and then we done a video, done some snapshots of the brace. And yeah, like I said yesterday, when we come out of the toilet block, we was in for a good session, and it's really looking that way. 8 fish now, 8 fish, 3 bream, which we're not really counting, that would put us on 11, lost 3. And yeah, so we ain't even baited up yet. That's just on like 1 fish at a time. On the GPS, we're finding the spots. But then today we'll go out and we'll bait up heavy with a boat. So that's what the morning's looking like in the swim. Might look neat, but it's pretty carnage. Everything is soaking wet. By the time I went round the sides of the bivvy to do up, cover the mozzie sides up, it, you know, two minutes, it was absolutely belching through. So, but the sun's up, we're in for probably high 80s today. So, catch you later. Right, these are the facilities. We've got all the charging station there, fridge freezers, shower block, 2 showers, actually nice, and toilet on the end. We're over there in peg 1, 0 first, then the 1. Got a whole lake to ourselves now for 2 nights. Got some guy coming on Saturday, but I don't think he'll go into the first 0. I'll bet he can have any double swim because there's no one on the lake. So happy days. Five takes last night, brought in two fish. I'm changing my hook pattern. I had the gardener curved hooks and they lost three fish. Had a bream, we both had a bream, so all together, eight takes in the first night, two bream, not too bad. But today's not. That was yesterday, to be fair. Today, we're really, really going to town now. We've got the boat, outboard motor. There's all the boats for the use. We're gonna bait our areas up. We know where we're fishing, exactly where we dropped the bait boats yesterday. We're gonna bait them areas right up and sit on them. And I think we're in for a good week. Right, Saturday, 8:30 p.m. Billy's got a bream. He won't bring the rod in. He knows he's got a bream, but he's chose to leave it, even though he knows it's a bream. But anyway, we're not really expecting anything until that sun goes down. When it goes down, from then till 6 in the morning, we're getting action. It's a bit hot today, to be fair. Bill's loved it. He likes basking in the sun. Oiled all up. Went out in the boat today. And what we done on our chosen spots, which are across the boys, but in, like I said, baited that right up. Plenty of bait, and now we're fishing on top of those. And apparently the guy isn't, well, there isn't anyone in Nault. So we've got a rod in this bay. And there's two guys fishing on the North Lepinet, which is obviously opposite. Probably can't see that, to be fair. But there's two guys over on that bank, which I think is swim 8. And then there's a French guy coming on Monday over here somewhere. Swim 10. Not too sure on them swims. That's Lepinet North. This is Lepinet South. So, like I say, what can you do? This is carp fishing. It's nice, not concerned at all. Like I say, we've had, how many fish, Bill? 7? Had the 7 and 4 bream. Lost three. I thought I had one snagged up. We went out in the boat. Both rods were tangled. And for some strange reason, the line was over the middle rope. So, it's a bit of a mystery, that one. But it was nice to get out in the boat today. Felt a little bit sick, to be honest. Billy's driving. But anyway, keep you updated on Sunday. Anything through the night, I'll put up. Sweet.
What's the weight of that, Bill?
I ain't weighed it yet. It's only in the low 20s. If that.
A little low 20 common.
Here, up.
Something.
You know it's going to flick. Nice.
All right, is that again?
32-pound mirror.
What was that caught on?
That was on a krill 18mm wafter on an IQD again. So a little bit of thunder about an hour ago. It's produced 3 fish this morning. Both had one in the night, so that's 5 fish in the last 6 hours. That's why I thought it was bigger.
So what size is that?
46 pounds.
So what rig do you catch that on?
That's on the IQD rig. On a...
Fish number 11. Just after midday, just about the roast dinner. Sun's gone in, overcast. Loads of rain earlier. Conditions are spot on. The time is now Monday, 4 o'clock. Now, We haven't had time to do any blog updates because it has been absolutely manic. So I don't really know where to start, so I'm gonna try and do it as I go along. When we come here, and I've already been here to the lake, the main thing is to do these blogs is to let people know what to expect when they come to a lake like this in France, especially Lepinet. So I've done a previous blog of my first experience here, and that's been picked up by a lot of people who fish here. There's two guys over there from Orpington and Kent. As soon as I drove around, they recognised me. Yeah, watch the video, because obviously they watch it because they're coming here. So they picked up on whatever I could say, what I experienced fishing here. And I've done the same with Billy. Told him what to expect. But this session, to be fair, we didn't know what to expect, did we? It was
unknown to me.
But this is not a runs water by far, so we've got to pinpoint why we're having a session like this. So what we chose to do, I said to Billy what I've done on my last trip, I basically done fish at a time, and I ended up getting into 23 fish. So what we've done this time, we said we're going to bait strategically, didn't we? Have heavy bait and
we're baiting across the middle.
Across the middle and fish over it, which we've done. And we are just getting run after run. And no exaggeration, we're 4 days in. This is the middle of our holiday now. So we're using today to experiment on what we feel can bring in a bigger fish. And I'll tell you how successful we've been. But now we want bigger fish. So we're going to call that pursuit of the 50, because we ain't had a 50 yet. We've had 3 40s, loads of 30s, loads of koi, ghost carp, commons. Without exaggeration, I've lost count. We've put it all on a whiteboard, which I'll put up.
25.
More than that, 38 runs.
Oh, 38, yeah.
38 runs. We can't put a rod out at the moment without it running within 20 minutes. And normally you'd be happy with that. This ain't a runs water. So we're saying, right, what we've got to do now is we've got to try...
I think the particle, though, is bringing, I don't know, like the bream and that in. So we're going to ease off of the particle and mainly boilie.
Concentrate and more on the boilie.
And up the size of the bait.
What we're also trying to do is, now, the first 3 days it was all IQD rig, weren't it? Yeah. And I've just put 3 rods out there with a Ronnie rig, IQD rig, and also a big IQ with a double wafter. And it's still got take. But that's all on our baited area. So the bait's still there. They ain't hoovered it up. We're holding them there.
And that was what? When did we put it out? We put it out...
We put it out on Saturday.
Saturday, yeah.
And it's now Monday. And we weren't really going to top that. We weren't going to top that area up probably till Tuesday / Wednesday for our last 3 days. So today is a bit of a learning curve. How to... can't emphasise how much, Bill.
Yeah.
To explain that this... It's been manic. We've had, without exaggeration,
I know they say
20 fish in 24 hours.
Yeah. On certain blogs I watch, in certain lakes, a lot of people that give you insight advise you, rest your rods, take them out of the swim for the day to rest the swim. At the moment, we've got 1 rod each in the swim, and that's not to rest the swim, that's the rest us.
Yeah, because we still want to be fishing. We're in France.
Because yesterday, 24 hours non-stop, run after run after run.
All through the night, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock.
And the size of the fish, a good stamp of fish, 30s and high 20s.
And like I say, how many 40s we had
now? I think we had a couple of 40s in yesterday. But yeah,
look, there you go. It's gonna go. But so what we're doing now,
and like I said earlier, we're calling it now Pursuit of the 50, aren't we?
Because love a 50.
We want a 50 out of it.
Yeah.
I had a 50 last time I come, and I was fortunate enough to get that as my, I think it was my second fish of my trip. And then after that, I had, I'm not sure if I had 250s. And then I had loads of 40s. I had more 40s than 30s, if I think right. But what we're doing, what we're getting now is we're getting more 30s than everything. But the last 24 hours or so, we're getting a lot of smaller fish, aren't we?
I think more so in the day, the smaller fish, especially with the particle. But we've even started baiting up other areas with just boilie.
And they're just taking everything, aren't they? They're just feeding mentally. Now there's two, I'll give an example.
But we did have, what day was it with the bad storm? I'll call it a bad storm.
Since the storm, yeah.
Because I've never experienced anything like
Friday
that.
Friday night we had an electric storm. 2 hours it lasted. We had more rain I've ever seen in a month. And it just lit up the lake for 2 hours. Lightning, the ground was shaking. And I'm not
exaggerating. That's no exaggeration.
The ground, my bed chair shook with the thunder. Since then, we had a mild one as well, 24 hours later, didn't we?
Yeah.
A little mild storm. And since then, it's gone absolutely manic. Now, we can't see what fish are going to pick up our bait. But what we do know is that we've got today to critically tweak things. Try things, you know, they always say, go to France, don't do anything different. You got to. Because if you're not doing anything different and you're picking up quite a few small fish, but we've had no end of big fish, don't get me wrong. But we want to be fishing now. We don't care, we need a big fish. One big fish, don't
one
we?
Big fish, yeah.
And we're targeting that, so.
What do they go up to in it? It's,
I think, 67.
67.
Yeah. So 63 to 67.
That's before spawning, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So them fish we've
spawned
caught,
out.
They've spawned out. You know, normally we'd probably have a 50 if we was later in the year. Might come back in September, we're thinking about it, haven't we?
But out of all the lakes I've personally done, I like to go to other lakes to experience it. But this, coming to France, this has got to be, it's got to be my top lake.
Yeah. Last time I fished here, I put it down as my top session I've ever had.
Not only for the fishing itself, but for the amenities, the pegs, everything about this lake, it ticks.
Nice little supermarket down the road, and what we found...
5 minutes. We timed it this morning from getting in the van at the peg, and that was unlocking the gate. 5 minutes
down to the supermarket.
To the supermarket, weren't it?
And then just off the supermarket. So basically, you come out of Lepinet, you come out the gate, you do a right, go as far as you can go, do a left, you see the supermarket. Easy as that. No traffic, no cars, nothing comes up this road because it's pretty much of a back street, but it's quite a main road. And off of that, in the village of Moray, there's a nice little lake we found, and it's literally opposite the supermarket. And they've got a big...
Like a cookout. It's like a cookout.
Hut, isn't it? Yeah. And they cook steaks, burgers, chips. We're going down there tomorrow.
And I must say, because buying meat over it...
fucking expensive.
...is expensive. But going down there and looking at the price of the steak and the meal,
you get a nice,
you're talking €20.
Nice fillet steak, chips, salad.
So we're going to do that tomorrow, yeah?
A couple of Britney Spit, well...
We did go down there today to have a rest, but it's shut on a Monday.
But this is, we're doing this blog, and I can't emphasise it enough, this is our rest. We ain't bothered about putting the rods out yet. I've got a stew to cook later. And I think we're just going to just keep one rod out each. Relax, have a couple of Britney Spears, and have a nice stew later, and take time on our rigs.
Yeah, going to make some new rigs up.
And, you know, double baiting, just trying. I'm even going back to a basic area with a double boilie.
That's not to say that they're not going to take anything, but
I think it's how we baited heavy. We baited heavy, and
this is what I was getting back to. There was two guys, two swims down. We met them, didn't we? Had a meal with them. They come up for a curry. They fish with us for the last two nights. They struggled. They had 13 fish, but well, I'll say struggled. I think they was up to 13 fish
by the time they left.
All week, between two of them, like six fish each. Would you be happy with that? Yeah, we've done it.
Of course, we've
come away.
I think everybody. It's the one fish. It doesn't matter about the poundage. It's that one fish
to get you
to say that you haven't blanked coming to France.
And then I drove round to see the other two fishermen over there, didn't I, yesterday? How are you getting on? You know, that they was 24 hours into their session. Oh, it's a bit slow. We're struggling. We're going to try some. They must have been looking over at us thinking.
But there again, I think it's the luck of the draw.
There ain't no draw, though. You pick your peg.
Luck
of the draw of what session you're going to get when you go away.
Exactly. And what peg you end up in. And at that time, what the weather's doing, where the wind's blowing.
And if you said it was going to be 30 degrees,
I'd have thought it would have been slow.
You're going to struggle and only catch at night. That's what happened before the storm, didn't it? We was only getting fish at night. After the storm, don't matter. What goes out, you're into a fish. So we thought we'd do really, really condensed chat now.
But it's like you say, people save their money. And for some people,
it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money.
It is a lot of money, especially with the cost of living and everything. And when people spend that money, they want to know what they're getting for that money. Everybody wants value for money now.
And that's the main reason behind my blogs. And Billy's, now Billy's, we used to fish a lot of time, but Billy obviously had to take a bit of time out, and now he's back on the scene. And these are why I do the blogs, you know, is to let people know, not to boast what fish you're getting and everything, but to let people know what it involves going to France, because of the money you're spending.
The total cost.
For you to make the right choice.
You know,
look at where I fished and go, do you know what, that guy's honest and he tells it how it is. And I would say, come to Lepinet.
Because in my time of fishing, obviously, I've heard a lot of fishermen's tales. They're stories, aren't they? And in reality, when you get there, what you've been told isn't necessarily
how it is.
How it is.
Like we went to La Russie, 2 months ago, didn't we? La Russie down near Le Mans.
Well, it's just an hour or so away.
We struggled, didn't we?
We did.
But we still.
But that was coming out of winter into spring.
We still pulled in 9 fish.
Yeah.
Up to 35 pounds. And it was a challenge. And I said to Billy, spawning on the bank, what would you rather have, a session like this or one big 16? That's an odd question, isn't it? I think you want both, but
of course you come fishing feel that bend in the rod.
I think you want
but
that.
I will say this, the fish in here, whether they're in their low 20s,
do they fight?
It's hard to tell because of the distance you're fishing.
And let's make that point as well. Now out to them boys, we've got the sonar and we've got the bait boat, we've got the rowing boat with the outboard motor. That is, if my boat don't lie,
122
metres we're dropping them at. It's about 130 to the boys, so we're dropping about five metres short of them boys across, which is a deep hole. And this side there's a shelf that comes back at that point, so if you get that critically right, you're going to be on the money. But what we've tried today, we've tried to do half the distance of the lake, just one drop at a time, haven't we? Before we think, shall we bait up? Because there's another little shelf. It goes down, which I don't know if Brian said,
we're actually fishing now in peg one, which is the first double on the gate side. But even if you're fishing peg zero, it doesn't look as though you've got a lot of water.
You have.
But I'm getting up 5 in the morning and sitting out here and watching. They're crashing all down.
Just boiling up some particles.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're crashing out.
I thought that was the sun.
They're crashing out and they're showing. I've been to France for a week and so has Billy. You don't see nothing. You know, you sit here and you you maybe see one fish show. What do? Do you fish on it? Our session really doesn't matter at the moment, but at least we know the fish are definitely down this end, whether that's down to our heavy baiting or we're being lucky. I've got to put it down to the heavy baiting. I really have.
Yeah.
Really have. I think they've found it and they're just staying there. Anyway, it's going to be a bit of a mess on the videoing, and we might not get everything in the critical order, but the reason I wanted to do it is because now, halfway through our session, we're in pursuit of a 50, aren't we?
Oh, most of them.
So if a 50 shows up on this video by the time it's being watched, it's because we're working for it.
Yeah.
We're not just fishing and hoping we're going to get a big fish. We are now trying, because we've had a good session. Even if we don't catch another fish, we go home happy as Larry.
What are you going to say this is?
Well, I know what it is.
What?
It's a 23 and a half, call it 24. 24. It's a 24 pound mirror. It's actually 23 and a half, but we call it 24. And this, like I said, is another unbelievable day of carp fishing on lepinet. There's just no end to it. One after the other. Do the other side, Bill. Do you always drop your fish?
No.
No, the reason I put that on there was because on my last blog, I got a comment saying, do you drop your fish? Mate, if you've never dropped a fish, not high up, but low down, like that. As long as you've got a nice padded cradle underneath, it's not a problem. Well done, Bill.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Go on.
Right, it's now Monday, 10 o'clock at night. Trust me, it just ain't easing up. For what we're doing today, we're getting back up there now in the big ones. Bill's just had a, what do you have, Bill, 25?
25.
I ain't weighed this yet, but we're guessing it's a low mid 30. So it's working. We've got four more days now to do our search for the 50. But it's relentless, Bill, isn't it?
It is.
Oh, it's relentless. Right, go on and press the button. 42 pound mirror. God, they do fight. Now, midday.
What was that caught on?
Double pop up call. Over hemp place. £42 caught on double corn.
Nice. Just going to show you the setup. Got the lucky Arsenal charm. Billy's out on the boat, out in the lake, he's lost his rod. Fish took it, got all tangled up, he went out in the boat, turned round, rod went sulking like a baby. Right atmosphere at the moment. You know what he's like.
17, 21 and a 25. Treble take.
IQD rig.
IQD rig again.
That was a
quail.
That was a
bigger
one than that.
live system off the...
They are so lively. Right this way. £30 mil. Billy's in as well. This is £29 common. Mirror. Caught on three pop up fake corn. Over 24 hours left, 36 hours exactly left. Billy's into his 20th breed.
I'm joking, I've done well.
Well, here we are, 10 o'clock at night on the final night, Lac de Lepinet. We've just landed the 60th carp. Packed down small, ready to go. All the big bivvies are down, all on the roof. Van's nearly full up. So, all the bait's gone. So if we do happen to get a fish, we'll just flick out. We've put some boilies. It's a little shelf, not far out, about 3 or 4 rod lengths. So we've chucked some boilies on that. So if we do get a fish, we can just flick out over that for the rest of the duration. So as I said, 60 fish caught, landed, 60 carp, one koi in that. On top of that, we had 5, I had 5 tench, but I had about 7-8 tench, couple of bream, and I think in total we lost about 15 fish. So what a trip. So when I put all this video together, you'll see the extent of it all. Cheers for watching.